Welcome to the January 5th meeting of the Jacksonville Youth Council. I would like to welcome our G10 viewers and those who are here with us today. We will now begin with the call to order. We'll the Pledge of Allegiance with Lauren Phillips, followed by the invocation by Christina Freeman.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please bow your heads with me. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us together today and equipping us with the right tools to go out there into the community and make it a better place. Please watch over us over this meeting and as we go on home. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I would now like to introduce the officers. I'm Christian Kelly.
I am Lauren Phillips, the Vice Chairman.
I'm Adej Wanoji Bobo, and I am the Secretary.
I'm Christina Freeman, and I'm the Recorder.
I'm Faye San Juan, and I'm Northside High School seat.
I'm Tatiana Manguel, and I'm the Jacksonville High School seat.
We will now be beginning with our team building activity, which will be done with Faye. We will now continue with old business. We'll be going to Lauren Phillips, who will give us a report on the Christmas Cheer Youth Day report.
On December 10th, some of the Jacksonville Youth Council members, we sorted canned goods to help the needy families during the holidays. And I wanted to say thank you for all those who participated. We had a really good turnout, and I had fun. I think it was good bonding time with us.
We'll now on to new business. We'll begin with a report on the National Day of Service with Tatiana Manguel.
The National Day of Service is held on January 16th on Martin Luther King Day. It's actually next Monday. We don't have any school. A sign-up sheet is going around now if you want to volunteer, come see me after the meeting. I'll have the sign-up sheet. We're going to be volunteering at the homeless shelter. And also, there will be a reminder sent out to everyone who signs up.
We will now move on to the Spring Break Planning Committee with Christina Freeman.
All right, so during Spring Break every year, the Jacksonville Youth Council participates in both social projects and service projects. In past years, for service projects, we've done both cleanups and going to the soup kitchen and giving a helping hand. For social projects, we have attended Carowinds and other amusement parks. Planning for the 2017 Spring Break projects are beginning soon. At this time, if anyone is interested, please raise your hand. All right. Concluding this meeting, we will meet to determine a schedule for the spring break.
Now onto Harmony News with Faith San Juan.
As of right now, Harmony is offering up to $1,000 in grants for youth-led projects, projects focused on teen bullying, substance abuse, or homelessness will have extra consideration during the selection process. Please see me after the meeting if you'd like an application for the grants. Applications are due January 13th, which is next Friday. Now on to the advisory summit discussion with Edejuan Ojibobo.
So on Tuesday this week, the executive committee and the upcoming executive committee attended the advisory committee summit, and this summit was with in accordance with the city council and other advisory committees in the city. So one of the things that they said at the summits was about changes that we want to make to improve our caring community in Jacksonville. So, and they want each advisory committee, including youth council, to adopt some of the items that were presented at the youth summit that we would like to see implemented in our community. So one of them is high school activities that don't just include sports. That is one of them that we will be adopting. And the second one is increase Jacksonville Youth Council visibility in schools. So the first one, what activities, actually I'm going to need ideas from you all. What activities, programs, and events outside of high school activities and sports would benefit your peers? So I'm going to get out that whiteboard so you can give me some ideas.
If you have any ideas to share, please come up to the podium so that we can hear you.
What about a book club? Book club.
Book.
Okay. Sorry.
So it was much like the youth summit that we had, right? Except it was all the city advisory committee, recreation committee, water and sewer committee. They all got together and we asked, how can we make Jacksonville a more caring community? And there were some issues brought up relative to youth, and so the youth council is going to take those on and try to bring them to fruition, right? So the questions that we're asking are just trying to generate some ideas on what, you know, you're thinking for your peers. You're representative of high school students in the community. What are activities, programs, and events outside of things that happen at your high school and sports that would you would like to see in this community that would benefit high school students in this community? And make sure you come to the podium if you have an idea.
Maybe like have a college night or something where you talk about the process of choosing the college or FAFSA, because there's a lot of high school students who don't know how the FAFSA, how to sign up for FAFSA or the process of, you know, looking for a college that's right for them. So something like that could be beneficial.
So we could do like a college night, maybe have some representatives from other schools.
Adding on to that, we could also include like some scholarships, like other people are handing out, and like some like how to do it. That'd be good.
Like financial aid?
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
Maybe like a job shadowing or career shadowing like type of thing. So.
That's great.
Like representatives from like different jobs to tell you about what they do and
maybe. Could you do like dad's a summer program maybe?
Yeah.
be good as leaders of Jacksonville to step up and form like a tutoring club for students who are struggling with their educational process, you know, as we're moving on to standardized testing coming up and things like that, especially for people who are juniors. It will be great to implement like the foundations that they're going to need to know. So that's a thought.
Thank you, Brooke.
That's great. Any other events like you've seen happen in other communities? Concerts, any type of event, places that you would like to see in Jacksonville that would cater to high school students that we can recommend to the city council?
I know the rec center has something coming up where they have a bus going to Raleigh to take people to a hockey game. And I feel if they had a lot of teens and they chip in a little bit of money, I think they'd enjoy that.
Like trips for teens.
Mm-hmm.
That's great. Excursions. What else?
What about a community talent show?
We used to have like a laser tag center and had like roller skating and different game machines and things like that, but I think they've transformed it into something else and we don't have that anymore, so I think it will be a safe way for teens to have fun after school. So
that's great.
And like maybe a trampoline park or something. Anything else? Okay, that's a fairly good list. The officers the new officers will kind of work with this and take it a little further, but we do have a second question here.
I actually have two suggestions for this one. The first one would be to kind of have a newsletter, sort of like the paper that we get in the beginning of this meeting, because a lot of the students I know at Jacksonville High School, they're not even aware that the Youth Council exists. I know I wasn't until a Deja One mentioned it to me. And the second one, let me go back to that one. The newsletter would consist of something like the activities that we do, the volunteer opportunities we have, and like the meetings that are coming up and things like that. And the second one would be a suggestion box, which would kind of help the Jacksonville High School seat, the Northside High School seat, and all the seats that we have. So the students could have some input, and we would know kind of how to help them more to suit their needs and to help their voice their opinions more to work together. Can we edit that out? Yeah.
Thank you. It's a great idea.
I think one way we can increase more awareness about Jacksonville Youth Council is through social media. I mean, we're the age of Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook and all that. If we use that, put the word about it, like she said, put pictures and tag different events that we're doing or have coming up, a lot of people will be aware about it and come and be like, okay, let me see what's going on and come out. And another way too is put in school announcements. I mean, not everybody do listen to announcements, but if you get it out there more enough and then also hashtag it and, you know, use social media, a lot of people will be aware about it and come join.
Great ideas. How many of you all like the Youth Council Facebook page? Okay, we need more likes. Okay, how many of you all have Facebook? Okay. Maybe not. There's not a lot of people use anymore, right? Snapchat? Yeah. Instagram? Yeah.
What about more summits and parties?
Fancy dinner or dance.
At the country club or anything? Like something like that.
I don't know if we'll be able to do that, but something like it.
Maybe we could try to host an event in conjunction with the school system. And so it's like held at a school or during a school day.
During the lunches, like sometimes colleges or like the Army recruiters would come. Maybe like you said, there's a different seat for each school. Some of you guys could take the time and set up a booth and explain like what the youth council does and about why you should join the club. I mean, I know one of the ways I got introduced to the club was seeing you guys at the Jacksonville Night Out. And then ever since then, I've been here. So, yeah.
We could like wear like our shirts around a lot, and we could also like hand out free merch, stuff like that. So,
fun T-shirts.
Adding on to what Tiana said, I know that Northside High School has what's called Power Hour, and it's an hour where we can do homework, or we can go visit teachers, or hang out with friends, or do whatever we want. But sometimes in the auditorium, we're offered lessons from speakers and different people who come to talk to us, as well as our own students speak out to other students at our school. So I think that, you know, me or Faith or Leslie, I know we all go to Northside, and one of us or all of us could go out and make a presentation and really present what we stand for and what we're about and how much fun we have. So,
have anything like that? It's Jacksonville that has the lunch.
We have Impact.
Yeah, we have Impact. We can make a video.
At Jacksonville?
Mm-hmm. Or like maybe we can get like the whole youth council together like at each school and we could all travel together and talk about it.
That when the freshmen first come to the school in the summer, a lot of the school clubs come and like represent the club, and so maybe youth council could do that.
White Oak.
All high schools do that, and they have like a big club meeting.
But we don't go to the high school one.
Why?
Or the White Oak one.
That's great.
We don't.
Just tell me if we don't go to the other schools.
Are there other schools that do the lunchtime activity? Richlands doesn't do that, do they?
Jacksonville.
Jacksonville does. White Oak does. White Oak does. Anybody from Southwest here? Okay. I'm going to pull it down so we can see it. Those are great ideas. Thank you all. And we'll be talking about these things some more. Some of these things we can do as a group, especially from the first list, and other things we can try to advocate for within the city. So just things that the officers will take back and create a plan of action.
We will now move on to the new officer's swear-in. Adejuan will present us with that.
Okay, the new officers, they'll be sworn in on January 17th at the city council meeting at 7 p.m. and everyone's welcome. Also tonight, I would like to welcome them on behalf of the Jacksonville Youth Council. If the officers could stand up as their name and position is called. Okay. For the 2017-18, this is our new Jacksonville Youth Council representatives, Adejuan Ojibobo, the chairman from Jacksonville High School. Also, I'm sorry if I mispronounced your name. So Seth Rutlinger, the vice chairman from White Oak High School. Brooke Gruber will be our secretary from Northside High School. Naya Thompson will be our recorder from Jacksonville High School. Taylor Rudder will be our White Oak High School seat from White Oak High School. Carolyn Marks will be the Jacksonville High School seat that goes to Jacksonville High School. Leslie Trong will be our Northside High School seat from Northside High School. Janelle Libby will be our at-large seat from Richlands High School.
I would now like to open the floor up to any public comments, and this may include any school events that may be coming up or anything that you would like to share with the audience. If you do, please come up to the podium.
I'd just like to say, we'll have new officers that will be in charge of our next meeting, but I just want to say thank you to our officers that are exiting, if you would give them a round of applause. They've done an excellent job in leading youth council. They're leaving it in very good hands, and I'm extremely proud of all of you. I appreciate all of you, and wish you nothing but the best in the future. And we'll do more at the end of the year when we do our senior send-off. So, but you guys are, I know Tatiana won't be here for that, so specifically, thank you, Tatiana. But you still get something from me for graduation. So you guys are wonderful. So
I would also like to thank Ms. Carmella for being a great leader for us and always leading us to the right path and showing us new opportunities and how to be a better person, a better leader.
I want to wish a good luck to all the new officers that are about to take in. Jacksonville is a great place, and let's make it a better community, and I know that you guys have the power to. I've know just about each and every one of you on a personal level now, and I believe in every single one of y'all, so good luck to it.
I would like to congratulate my fellow peer, Tatiana Manguel,
for being accepted into University of Baltimore with a full ride scholarship.
Anybody else aware of their future plans yet, or maybe we should wait till the end of the year for that?
I got you. I know mine.
Well, it's what we want.
Yeah.
I can tell you what we want.
Currently, I early applied to UNC Chapel Hill. Hopefully, cross our fingers. I should be hearing back from them rather soon. I'm going for political science. I want to end up being a lawyer and then eventually working my way up in the political field and hopefully being Secretary of State one day. That's the big goal.
Well, she has her future pretty well planned out. I'm still kind of on the edge. I definitely know I want to go to UNCW, and I believe I want to be a math teacher, but I'm not for sure. So.
Applied to UNC and some other colleges, but I'm hoping to get in there, and I want to go into dentistry. So, yeah.
In 2 years? I will be applying to Georgetown University, and I'll be looking into majoring in finance or economics, and then get my master's in that, probably go to law school, and maybe become president of the United States.
Any other good news, public comments?
Faith's turn.
Oh. I recently applied to NC State University. I plan on graduating with a bachelor's degree in computer science. So, yep.
I plan to go to school to become a doctor in the psychology field, and I'm also going to study some political science because I want to be a senator and hopefully the first woman president.
If that is all for public comments, I would like to announce that the next meeting of the Jacksonville Youth Council will be February 2nd, 2017, as well. And I would like to just wish a good luck to the new officers that will be taking our positions. If that is all, I now adjourn this meeting of the Jacksonville Youth Council.